हेलो फ्रेंड्स, तो टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मोड फॉर सम डेटा इन द स्टैटिस्टिक्स. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट मोड ऑफ अ ग्रुप्ड डेटा. ओके, जस्ट लाइक यू हैव स्टडीड इन योर क्लास 9th अबाउट द मोड कैलकुलेशन ऑफ अनग्रुप्ड डेटा, वी कंटिन्यूड दैट सेम डिस्कशन एंड अप्लाइड द कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर द ग्रुप्ड डेटा. नाउ वी विल अप्लाई द सेम काइंड ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट for one more interesting term, that is median. Till now you have studied about median in your class 9th, that is how to calculate the median, what exactly is the median. So first let us discuss from that only, let us get a quick recap of what you have studied till now in your class 9th. Median means what? Median is basically, it is the measure of central tendency. Now again, this is a very technical term, central tendency. What exactly is meant by central tendency? See, central tendency means the value, okay, the observation which is middle most. Okay, as the term suggests, central. Central means in the center, in the middle. Okay, so I will say median is basically the middlemost value of a data. Okay, of a set of data, the middlemost value will be known as the median. You have studied how to calculate the median of an ungrouped data. If I have some data, what I need to do? I need to arrange it in the ascending order or maybe in the descending order, and then I will see the observation which is in the middle of this data, and based on that I will judge what exactly the median is. Okay, so you have studied that how to calculate median of ungrouped data. That what exactly is ungrouped data, which has no class, which has no foundation, and how to calculate the median of that kind of data. You have studied it very properly in that in the class 9th. You have learned that arrange the data in ascending order, and if n is what? N means number of observations, that how many times you have done the observation, on how many people you have done the observation, is that is equals to n. Okay, so if n is equals to an odd number, we say median will be n plus 1 by 2 th observation, and if n is even, we say median will be equals to n by 2 th observation. Okay, we have studied this concept very properly in class 9. So let's take one example and let's get a quick recap of what we have studied in class 9th, how we have calculated the median in class 9th. Okay, because it will help us to understand, to continue our discussion and apply this concept on grouped data. Okay, grouped data means which has class, upper class, lower class, you have studied this. Okay, so let's take one example. The example says, let us say we have an exam of 50 marks. Let us say we have an exam of 50 marks, and in this exam, in this 50 marks exam, let us say I have 100 students. Let us say 100 students appeared for this 50 marks exam, and in this exam what I got is that the marks obtained by different students. Okay, I got a data related to marks obtained by different students. So marks obtained and number of students I have taken this example from the NCERT book. It's a very good book, and let us understand this example thoroughly. I have a data related to marks obtained by the students. Let us say the marks obtained by the students is 20, and this is 6, then 29, this is 28, this is 28, and this is 24, 33, 15, then 42, then 2, then further I will extend this table, 38, 4, 43, 1, and 25, 20. Okay. So this is the data that I have. I have this data which says, which is a data of an exam in which 100 students appeared, and the total marks of that exam, maximum marks of that exam is 50 marks. Okay. So what I can see, I have a data in which this is the marks obtained by students, and this is the frequency of students. Okay, you know very well what is the term frequency. You are very much familiar with this term. So this is the frequency of the students. It means if 20 marks, if I see 20 marks, so 6 students have got 20 marks, 28 students got 29 marks, 24 students got 28 marks. Okay, so in the class of 100 students, I have 24 students which got 28 marks. Similarly, there is only one student who scored 43 marks out of 50. So might be he's the very brilliant guy. This 20 students got only 25 marks. Okay, so this is how I have a data. Now my task is to calculate the median of this data. Now once again, this data is an ungrouped data. Okay, you have studied this in class 9. Ungrouped data means there is no kind of class available in this marks obtained. Okay, in this observations, you can see this is not a range, this is the marks, exactly 20 marks. If I make it like 20 to 25, 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 35 to 40, and so on, it will become a grouped data, but I am considering the ungrouped data. So first step to calculate the median of this kind of data is, first I need to arrange this data in the ascending order. Okay, I will arrange the data in the ascending order. So how will I arrange the data in ascending order? I will write here, I will write here marks obtained okay. I have one column as marks obtained, and then another column as frequency. And frequency is what? It is the number of students. Okay, nothing but the number of students is my frequency. So first I will arrange the data here. See, marks obtained is the minimum marks is 20, the least marks scored by the student is 20, and this is obtained by 6 students. Okay, and then the second is, which is the second least marks? Second, this is the 25. So 25 marks is obtained by 20 students, as I can see in the data. And then after 25, I have one more, that is 29. So 29 marks is obtained by 28 students. And then again, after 28, we have 28 also. So 28 marks is obtained by how many students? You can see it is obtained by 24 students. And then I have 29. So 29 marks is obtained by 28 students. And then what else? After 29, which is the smallest value? 33, 38, 43. Okay, so 33 is the small value. So 33 marks obtained by, there is 15 students. Okay. And after 33, I have 38. 38 marks is obtained by 4 students, as you can see there. Then after 38, I have 42 marks. So 42 marks is scored by 2 students, and then I have 43 marks, it is scored by only 1 student. Okay, and if you add the students, if you add this frequency, it come out to be 100. The sum of these values is, it is 100, because 100 students gave the exam. So the value of n is 100. N means the number of observation, the number of times you repeated an experiment, number of times you have taken the observation. So you have taken the data of 100 students, that's why I will say n is equals to 100. Okay. Now, so what we have done is, we have arranged the data in the ascending order. As you can see here, this is the data and this is the data. I arranged this data in the ascending order. I have written the marks of the student here, and correspondingly the frequency, the number of students obtained this particular marks. Okay. So this is how I made the table. Now, as you can see in this table, this is the marks obtained, this is frequency, and as we said, to obtain median, I need to apply the concept of this. If n is odd, then I will apply the median is n plus 1 by 2 th observation, means the observation which is at this place. Okay. And if n is even, I will apply, the median will be average of n by 2 th and n plus 1 by 2 th observation. Okay. The average of these two observation will be my median. Now, as here I can see the value of n is 100. So n is what? N is an even number. Now, if n is an even number, I will see n by 2 th observation will be 100 by 2, that is 50th observation, and n plus 1 by 2 th observation will be, n by 2 plus 1, here also I written it wrong. See, this is n by 2 plus 1. So n by 2 plus 1 th observation will be 100 by 2 plus 1, that is 51st observation. So my median will be the average value of 50th observation and 51st observation in my data, wherever the 50th observation is and wherever the 51st observation is. The mean, the average of those two values will be my median. Okay. So how to calculate the 50th observation and 51st observation? Let us see this. Let us calculate this. Now for that, I have to rub this much part written. So if you want, you can note down this in your notebook. You can pause the video and note this in your notebook so that I can rub this much part. Okay, so let us write down the marks obtained by the student, and in this case, now marks obtained by the student, I will write the cumulative marks. Okay, I will write the marks like this. For example, this is the number of students. So number of students. Okay, so first marks is, where it is, it is 20. So 20 marks is obtained by 6 students. Okay, 20 marks is obtained by 6 students, and then the second observation is 25. So here I will write marks up to 25. Up to 25 marks is scored by how many students? See, 20 marks is scored by 6 students, 25 marks is scored by 20 students. So if I see up to 25 means adding these two, I will get 20 plus 6, that is 26 students. So here it will come out to be 6 plus 20, that is 26 students. So here I have 26 students. Similarly, the next observation is 28. So the next is, how many students obtained marks up to 28? So for 28, what I need to do? I will simply add this 24 in that 26, because up to 26, up to 25 I have 26 students. So up to 28 will be extra students which obtained 28 marks. So it will come out to be 26 plus 24. So if you add these two value, it will come out to be 50. Okay. So up to 28 marks, I have 50 students out of 100. Okay. Now next value is what? It is, you can see it is 29. So up to 29 marks. Up to 29 marks, how many students are there for 29? It is 28 students. So here I will write, I will add these 28 students in the previous 50 students, so it will come out to be 78. Okay, it will come out to be 78. Similarly, 33, so up to 33, so up to 33 marks, how many students got up to 33? I will add this 15. So 78 plus 15. So just add these value. How will you add this? First add 20 to this 78. It will give you 98. Okay. Then subtract 5. So 98 minus 5 will give you 93. So it would be a better oral addition. Okay. Directly adding in your mind, it will be easy. Instead of writing on notebook just 78 and 15 and you are adding this. Instead of that, try to add it mentally. Okay. Now up to 38 students, so up to 38 students, up to 38 students, how many marks, how many students are there? 4 students extra. So here I will write 93 plus 4, this will give you 97. So these are the students up to 38, then up to 42. Then up to 42, how many students are there? There are 2 more students. So up to 42, I will add 97 plus 2. It will give you 99. So 99 students are there till 42. Okay. And then I have 43. So up to 43. I will add 99 plus 1 and this will give you 100. Okay, so finally I got here 100, that those students who got marks up to 43 is 100, and this is also confirmed by our data. This is our data, it clearly says that there is only one student who scored the 43 and no student is above this student. The maximum marks that the student scored is 43. So till 43 I should get here 100. Okay, so this is like a verification that my addition is correct here. What I have done is the addition is perfectly correct. The reason is up to 43 I should get 100 students. Why? Because there is only one student who scored 43 and that is the highest. Means there is no student who scored more than 43 marks. Okay. So here we will make a cumulative frequency table. Okay. So cumulative frequency table. So cumulative frequency table, here I will get 6, then 26, then 50, then 78, 93, 97, 99, and this is 100. So this is the cumulative frequency table. Okay. Now my task is to calculate 50th observation. Okay. My task is to calculate the 50th observation, that is student who is at the 50th place. So since I have arranged the data in the ascending order, I can directly get the ranks of the student. What I can say, there are 6 students in the top 6 rank. Okay, then those students who have obtained up to 25 marks are in the rank up to 26. Okay, their rank is between 26. What I am saying is, just I need to identify that how many students are above this 50th marks, okay, or in the range of 50th marks, then I can get my required data easily. Now what I can see, that if I say up to 28 marks, you can see up to 25 marks there are 26 students, and those students who scored 28 marks, you can see here those students who scored 28 marks were 24. So after these 26 students, the rest of the 24 students, okay, the rest of the 24 students, they scored 28 marks. So the 50th observation that I want to calculate, I can see the 50th student lie in this range, okay, lie in this category. And since 26 students are up to 25 marks, and after that 50 students are up to 28 marks. So my 50th observation lies in this category, and I can very easily say that my 50th observation will be equals to 28. Okay, the 50th observation will be equals to 28. And similarly, if I want to calculate 51st observation, how will I calculate the 51st observation? See, up to 50 students are here, and the 51st student, okay, who the student who is at the 51st rank will be in the next category, that is 28. Now you can see, 29. In 29, you have 28 students, okay. So there is the student, 51st student who scored 29 marks. So I can very easily say 51st observation would be 29, okay. Now, how to calculate the median? The median will be, average of these two values. So median will be 28 plus 29 upon 2, that is 28.5. So the median of this given data is 28.5. Now what does this median is representing? Median represents the central tendency. Now what is central tendency? The median says that since median is 28.5, so 50% of the students are above this 28.5 marks, and 50% of the students are below this 28.5 marks, okay. So it's like 50-50, okay, it is like balancing the values. So this median says 50% student are above 28 marks. Above 28 means maybe they scored 29, maybe they scored 33 or 38 or 42 or 43, but 28.5 also says that 50% of the students are below this marks. So below means maybe they scored 28, maybe they scored 25, or maybe they scored 6, okay. So in this way we can calculate the median, and median is helping us to calculate the central value, the central tendency. See, mean will never give you that value which is says that maybe the 50% or 50% observations are above or less or below the mean. It do not say that. Mean is not a central tendency. The median is the accurate central tendency value, okay. So if you calculate the mean of this data, the mean will not give you 28.5, it will give you some other value, okay.